Thank you for joining the Algonquin College Accessibility Tutorials. Today we will be discussing how to create accessible Excel spreadsheets. We'll start with formatting your cells. In order to provide structure, meaning, and ease in navigation, cells can be given name styles. To apply name styles, select the desired cells or an entire row or column by using the row or column indicator. So we'll select all these cells. Go to the Home tab and then Cell Styles in the Styles group and choose the style you'd like, in this case, Calculation. If you wish to change any of the styles, simply right-click it and select Modify from the drop-down menu. You can add further structure by selecting cell types from the Number section of the Home tab. Choose from Currency, Accounting, Date and Time, etc., etc. Lastly, avoid merging cells because merged cells can be difficult for persons with disabilities to work with. Next, try using cell addressing. You can name a section of cells to make it even easier to navigate throughout all the information. To set a cell name, select the data range you would like to group together. Click to the Formulas tab. In the Defined Name section, click Define Name and type the name in the Name text box. In the Scope drop-down list, select the scope within which the name can be referenced. When you're finished, click OK. Make sure that you name all your tabs to provide information about what is found on the worksheet, making it easier to navigate throughout a workbook. To rename a sheet, right-click on the Sheet tab and then click Rename. Type a brief, unique name that is descriptive of the sheet's contents. In order to create accessible tables, you need to make sure that you provide clear navigation so that screen reading software will be able to properly read the table. Try and keep your tables as simple as possible by avoiding merged cells and dividing complex data into separate tables. Blank cells, rows, or columns could mislead a screen reader into thinking that there is nothing beyond the blank cells, so remove any unnecessary blank cells within your table. Table header cell labels should be concise and clear. Table headers need to be specified to help interpret the other cells in the table. To specify a header row in a table, start by clicking anywhere in the table and opening the Table Tools Design tab. In the Table Style Options group, select the Header Row checkbox and add your header information. If a table splits across pages, set the header to show at the top of each page. Also set the table to break between rows instead of in the middle of rows. Charts can be an efficient means of conveying information. That being said, special steps need to be taken to ensure that your chart is accessible. After you have created a chart, select the Layout tab in the Chart Tools section. Here you can add labels to your chart. Add as many labels as applicable, ensuring that you add at least a title and a vertical and a horizontal axes label. Make sure that you use more than just color to distinguish between the different bars or lines. Try using shape, texture, and different types of lines as well. To change the type of line, select the line and click on the Chart Tools Format tab. Select Shape Outline and then dashes or arrows for different types of lines. Weight can also be used to adjust the weight of the line. Thank you for joining us in learning how to create accessible Excel spreadsheets.